The U-Step mounting bracket both support permanent and non-permanent assembly. For the non-permanent solution, you will need the components seen on the table. Firstly, you will need to insert the encoder magnet. It should be placed straight in the center. Afterwards, place the U-Step on top of the mounting bracket. Insert the nut on the opposite side of the U-Step. Secure them with a finger so they don't fall out. Then lightly put the bolts in place. And tighten them with a screwdriver. Lastly, we need to insert the smaller magnets inside the mounting bracket to secure the U-stepper on the motor. Apply the double-sided tape to the magnets. Afterwards, remove the protective strip. This can easily be done with a tweezer. Now you can use the screwdriver used previously to insert the magnet securely. Remember to aim the stick side towards the mounting bracket. Repeat the same process with the other magnet. And you're done. Now you can mount the bracket to the motor and get started building. To permanently mount the U-stepper to the motor, you'll need the materials shown on the table. Firstly, we'll insert the encoder magnet and make sure that it's centered. Then we undo two screws from the motor. Place the mounting bracket on top of the motor. Now use the screws that you received with the U-stepper and just place them without screwing them in. Now take the nuts that you received and place them under the mounting bracket on the remaining two holes. If this proves difficult, you can easily adjust the nuts with a screwdriver. Now push down the mounting bracket towards the motor and make sure that the nut sits inside the mounting bracket. You can now secure the screws. Last step is mounting the U-stepper to the bracket. For this, we just need to place the U-stepper on top of the mounting bracket, put the small screws in, and secure them with a screwdriver. And voila! After assembling the U-stepper, we can apply the heatsink that came with the U-stepper. For this, you first need to remove the protective strip from the heatsink. To remove it more easily, you can use a tweezer for this task. Now place the heatsink on the stepper driver's thermal pad and make sure it sits evenly. When you apply the heatsink, make sure it has some space to the other components, as it could cause a shortage if placed badly. And you're good to go.